So the situation for the third row, for the group widget for results, is a bit more complicated because it wasn't possible to add the QWebView widget for showing the web map from within Qt Designer. Instead, I'm just going to set things up so that we can later add this widget from our code. The group box, the content of the group box is organized into two rows, one with the lids widget and later on the web view, and one with the three buttons below it. So the organization will be a vertical layout containing two horizontal layouts for the two different rows. I'm going to start by adding the first horizontal layout. So I'm picking a horizontal layout from the widget list in Qt Designer, and I'm going to use the hierarchy to do that. So I'm dragging it over to the hierarchy and dropping it on top of the group box for the third row. So we have now a child of that group box with the horizontal layout. And since this is very important, I'm going to already rename it correctly so that it's clear where you have to do that. So I'm going to call that horizontal layout results list and map HBL for horizontal box layout. Like this. Okay, and now we can add the list view widget to it. There we have to pick the list view widget under item views model based. So it's important to pick this one, not the list widget. So the list view, and we drag it over and drop it on top of the horizontal layout we just created, like this. That's all we have to do for this first row. As I said, the Qt web view will be added later to the right of the list view widget from the code. So now we add a second horizontal layout below the first one. And this one is the one that should have the three buttons. So I'm now going to drag three push button widgets and dropping them on top of the layout in the hierarchy window. The first one, the second one, and the third one. And the last thing is I'm going to use the horizontal spacer again so that these buttons are all pushed all over to the left. I have to aim very carefully until the blue bar appears on the right of the third button, and then you get the desired layout. So still have to change the names of the titles of these buttons. The first one should be called Clear Selection. The second one should be called Select All. And the third one should be called Invert Selection. And that's it, we're done with the third row of our layout.